Hello friends, you are welcome. So today I am going to discuss the next practical. The name of today's practical is maceration technique. So aim of this experiment, to macerate the given plant material. For performing this experiment, we should require the plant material. So you may take any suitable fresh plant material, for example cucurbita, thuja, etc. Then we should require also the chemicals, 10% nitric acid, 10% chromic acid, then aqueous saponin and glycerin. These are the chemicals required for performing this experiment. Then apparatus, we should require test tubes, test tube holder, spirit lamp, watch glass, brush, glass rod, needle, slide and cover slips. Then for doing this experiment, for performing this experiment, maceration technique, different workers have proposed different methods for separation of cells. That means this maceration technique is the technique of separation of cells. So there is a Jeffries method as well as Schultz method. So as per the Jeffries method, we should follow these steps and prepare the slide. So we have to take the plant material. For example, I have taken cucurbita stem. So take small 1-inch length piece of the cucurbita and take small slices. Longitudinally you have to cut the cucurbita stem. That means you have to take thin slices of the cucurbita fresh stem. Then boil these slices in a test tube containing water. Then you should take these two chemicals, 10% nitric acid and 10% chromic acid, in the same test tube, another test tube, fresh test tube, and by adding these two chemicals, 10% nitric acid and 10% chromic acid, in equal amount, you should put the slices of this plant material in the test tube containing these two chemicals, 10% nitric acid and 10% chromic acid. Then boil this test tube, on a spirit lamp. So our purpose of boiling the slices on the plant material in this nitric acid and chromic acid in a test tube. So in order to soften the plant tissue, so after boiling for few minutes, tissues in the plant material get softens, and afterwards you have to drain out the macerated material. Then wash this material slices with water in order to remove the traces of these acids. Then take this material on a slide, clean slide, and tease material with the help of needles lengthwise in order to separate the different elements. Then stain the material in aqueous saponin. After staining this aqueous material in aqueous saponin, mount the material in glycerin and observe under microscope. So this is a very simple technique as per the Jeffries method. So after preparation of slide, you have to observe this slide under microscope. So what is the purpose of making this maceration? So main purpose of making the maceration technique is to separate the cells. Why we separate the cells? Because in different plant organs, different types of tissues are there, and these different tissues are made up of different types of cells. For example, if we take the complex tissues like xylem and phloem, xylem is made up of four different types of elements like tracheids, vessels, fibers and xylem parenchyma. If we take another conducting tissue, phloem, it is also made up of four different types of elements like pseudotubes, comparent cells, phloem fibers, phloem parenchyma. So if we observe under microscope by taking the transverse section of any plant material, if we want to observe the three-dimensional structure of these different elements of this xylem like tracheids, vessels, fibers and parenchyma in transverse view. In transverse view, vessels are looking like such circular patches. Tracheids and fibers are looking like such polygonal or hexagonal patches. That means the exact lines are, vessels are not such circular patches. Tracheids and fibers are not such hexagonal, polygonal patches. That means the vessels, tracheids, fibers, these elements in the xylem, we want to separate. So for separation of these different elements of the xylem, as well as phloem, as well as any plant tissue, in order to separate the cells, we must use the chemicals. And different workers, by their different methods, have proposed the different techniques. As per the Jeffries method, this 10% nitric acid and 10% glycerin acid should be used for softening the tissue. So purpose of softening of tissue is to separate the cells. For example, this is the one type of tissue. So this tissue is made up of different types of cells. So in between the cells, there is a middle lamina. In between the neighboring cell, there is a middle lamina. So this middle lamina acts as a cementing material. This material is made up of pectin compound. This pectin material acts as a sealing material and binds these neighboring cells together. That means if we dissolve this pectin material, middle lamella, by boiling this tissue in a nitric acid and chromic acid, then and then only this pectic acid dissolves and cell gets separated. Cell gets separated. That means our purpose of maceration is to separate the cells. Separate the cells. So by using this technique, we can separate the different types of cells or different types of elements in different tissues. For example, if we take the material, boil in chromic acid and nitric acid, then wash with water, then stain with saccharin, mount in glycerin, and observe under microscope. We can observe the tracheids with different thickenings, like annular thickening, spiral thickening, scalary bond thickening, etc. So theoretically we know tracheids are made up of thick walled lignified elements. Tracheids are made up of tracheidal cells. So these tracheidal cells are the cells which are having lignified walls and tapering ends. The lignified walls and tapering ends, this is the character of tracheid. And these tracheids possess different types of thickenings, like annular, spiral, scalariform, reticulate, as well as simple pits or circular border pits. So if we take transverse section, we can't observe the thickenings. If we take the transverse section, we can't observe the entire structure, three-dimensional structure of the tracheid. That's why we separate the cells by this, using this maceration technique, by using different chemicals, and we can easily understand the three-dimensional structure of the tracheid and different types of thickenings on the tracheids. Another element which is found in xylem is a vessel. So vessels are made up of tubular elongated cells which are placed one above the other. So these vessels are tube-like structures. These are also having thick lignified walls, and as like tracheids, vessels also shows different types of thickenings, like spiral thickening, annular thickening, as well as scalariform thickening, as well as pitted thickening, border pitted thickening. It may be simple pits or circular border pits. Last, another element is fiber. That means xylem is made up of four elements: tracheids, vessels, fibers, and parenchyma. So if we separate these four elements of xylem by the maceration technique, we can also identify very easily in our slide the fibers. So fibers are associated with the other elements of xylem lobe, like vessels and tracheids. So fibers are elongated cells having tapering or narrow ends and narrow lumen. So walls of these tracheids, fibers, they are also lignified. And these fibers are elongated cells having tapering ends and narrow lumen. So in this fashion, by using this technique, maceration technique, we can separate the different types of elements of xylem, different types of elements of phloem, as well as any other tissue. We can separate from, the cells can be separate from tissue, and we can identify the three-dimensional structure of each and every element of the any tissue. So that's all about the today's practical maceration technique.